Happy Easter. Oh, yes, that's Happy Easter.
Very good.
Good. The people say hi. Tim.
Good morning. Welcome to St. Maximilian Kolbe Parish. There will be no morning mass on Wednesday, April 3rd at St. Mary's, or Thursday, April 4th at Epiphany. Today is Easter Sunday of the Resurrection of the Lord. On this day of days, we offer a joyful sacrifice of praise to the Father who raised his Son from the dead. Let us be intent upon the life Christ offers us, Christ our Passover, who has been sacrificed. Readings for today are number 827 in the Glory and Praise book, and our entrance hymn is number 330, Jesus Christ is risen today. Welcome again to the service this morning. Happy Easter morning.
Happy Easter.
We have also our brothers and sisters who are praying with us through the live stream. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd leading us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
This day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter proceeded to speak and said, "You know what has happened all over Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John preached, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power. He went about doing good and healing all those oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses of all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree. This man God raised on the third day and granted that he be visible, not to all the people, but to us, the witnesses chosen by God in advance, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead." He commissioned us to preach to the people and testify that he is the one appointed by God as judge of the living and the dead. To him all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him will receive forgiveness of sins through his name. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad. The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. I shall not
a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brothers and sisters, if then you were raised with Christ, seek what is above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Think of what is above, not of what is on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, your life, appears, then you too will appear with him in glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning, while it was still dark, and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved, and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. They both ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial cloths there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial cloths there, and the cloth that had covered his head, not with the other burial cloths, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he had to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
If we had been at the Easter Vigil last night, we would have experienced the emergence of light from darkness. We would have been holding candles and hearing the church singing praises for the light of Christ in our lives. Taking this a little bit further, we might see how this ritual of the lights is really a mirror of our struggles and efforts as a people, as a church, and as individuals to find our way through the darkness, the pitfalls, and the faults of our lives, to find meaning, direction, and goodness. We as Christians eventually find that it is Jesus who brings meaning, direction, goodness, and light to our lives. The Old Testament readings from the Easter Vigil also trace the relationship not only of the Jewish people with God, but that of all of humanity with God. In the beginning, as it is told in the book of Genesis, God created all things, seen and unseen. And that God further states that all creation is good. God created all things out of goodness and love. But something happened when humanity later decided to turn away from a right relationship with God. It is as if it wasn't, and still to this day, is as if all of us have been blinded and sent into darkness by an arrogance that overtakes our spirits. We actually think sometimes that we don't need God in our lives, or that God's way just isn't for us. Many of the Old Testament stories go on to describe the tension that has developed between God and humanity. Several times, God grew angry. And several times, God, out of love for all of us, extended the opportunity to repair our relationship with God. Turning to the New Testament, we can find a parable that describes the master of the vineyard who sends his messengers to the caretakers in an attempt to repair the relationship between the master and the caretakers that has gone sour. The messengers were treated poorly, their message scoffed at, and sometimes they were physically abused and beaten. Finally, the master sends his only son to repair the damage, and still the caretakers refuse to mend their ways. They eventually throw the master's son out of the vineyard and kill him. This parable tells the story of our relationship with God as a people, as a church, as individuals throughout all of history. You might even say to this very day. It also tells the story of Jesus breaking into our world as broken and lost as it is, to bring light, goodness, and the promise of forgiveness, salvation, and the chance to rebuild our a loving relationship with God. For it is also written that God so loved the world that he sent his only son to repair our damaged relationship. And so it is that the story of Easter is a story of God's unimaginable love for all of us. So much so that even in the midst of the darkness that may lie within our hearts and our souls, that Jesus breaks through with that divine love and light to bring goodness and rebirth to our spirits and our relationship with God. And this is what excited Mary of Magdala, Peter, and the other disciple as they visited the tomb on that very first Easter Sunday. As it is written in today's gospel reading. Let us imagine for ourselves that great joy and even disbelief that Mary of Magdala, Peter, and the other disciples experienced that very first Easter morning as they discovered that the body of Jesus was no longer in the tomb, that he was truly risen from the dead, just as he said that he would. Let us not only imagine, but experience within the depths of our hearts and our souls the great and overwhelming divine love that broke through all of the violence that was inflicted upon Jesus on the days that led up to his death on the cross. Perhaps we may never fully understand the power of love, certainly not to the extent that God has expressed it to us through the actions of his only beloved Son, Jesus. And yet God so loved the world and us that it seems almost unbelievable, certainly unimaginable. But it is upon us to accept that love, to let it grow within our hearts and our souls, and to share it with one another, friend or stranger, rich or poor. Finally, may we learn to live in that love and express our joy and gratitude for the great gift of salvation and reconciliation that God has granted to us. May we express our gratitude to Jesus for the great and the wonderful work that he has done to save us from the darkness that sometimes overtakes our spirits.
Today, for profession of faith, we renew our baptismal promises. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism, so that we may walk with him in the newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of the holy baptism, by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promise to serve God and the Holy Catholic Church. And now I ask you, do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and the prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us a new birth in water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness for our sins. Keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen.
That our Holy Father, Pope Francis, will inspire renewed Easter faith and encourage Christ-based love for the poor of the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the leaders of nations ensure to every person the free exercise of religion, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the newly baptized and newly received continue their lifelong journey into the Paschal mystery, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those crushed by addiction, depression, and grief rise to new life through the grace and mercy of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the living body of Christ gathered here nourish the spirits of those who have received the Easter sacraments, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we support each other as we journey toward the future of our cluster, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the people of St. Maximilian Kolbe and St. Catherine Drexel parishes for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those listed in our Book of Intentions and our bulletin prayer list, for those in our memorial book, for all our benefactors, and all that is in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Hail Mary,
full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Marked with the
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, will become our bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. For through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Lord God, we ask you to receive us. Be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you in humble and contrite hearts. Pray that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Exultant with the paschal gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which Your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb that has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome by the Paschal joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless this gift, these offerings, this holy and unblemished sacrifice, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Salvator, our Bishop, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith. Remember, Lord, your servants, and all gathered here whose faith and devotion is known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise, or they offer it themselves, for all who are dear to them, for the redemption of their souls, in hope and health and well-being, and paying their homage to you, eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in flesh, and in communion, in whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious ever Virgin Mary, Mother of our God and Lord Jesus Christ, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul and Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, Jude, Linus, Clentu, Clemens, Sixtus, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosma and Damian, and all your saints, We ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things we may be defended by your protecting help. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, which we make to you, also for those whom you have been pleased to give the new birth of water and the Holy Spirit, granting them forgiveness of all their sins. Order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, to bless and acknowledge and approve these offerings in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with his eyes raised up to heaven, to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessings, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessings, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty, from the gifts that you have given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you are pleased to accept the gifts of your servant, Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that this gift be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who, through this participation at the altar, receive the most holy body and blood of your Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessings. Remember also, Lord, your servants, who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace. To us also, your servants, those sinners, hope in the abundance of your mercy, graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord, through whom you continue to make these good things, O Lord. You sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostle, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of our risen Lord be with you all always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Spoke unto the three, your Lord has gone to Galilee. Alleluia.
Let us pray. Look upon your church, O Lord, with unfailing love and favor, so that renewed by the Paschal mysteries, she may come to the glory of resurrection through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We bow our heads for God's blessing. May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity, and in the conversion defend you from every assault of sin.
Amen.
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 And may he who restored you to eternal life in resurrection of his only begotten Son endow you with the peace of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to close, may you who celebrate with gladness the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exulting in his spirit to those feasts of celebrating eternal joy.
Amen.
And may the blessing Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you always.
Amen.
We wish all the families and visiting people and friends joyful Easter. Wishing every family to celebrate. We show people whom we are in the way we celebrate. Happy Easter.
Happy Easter, Father.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.